Electron diffraction. With the experiment on electron diffraction, it can be shown that electrons which are classically clearly classified as particles have wave properties. The hypothesis put forward by de Broglie that the dual wave particle relationship p equals h bar times k with the momentum p and the wave number k also applies to massive particles such as electrons can be verified. The experimental setup consists of an electron tube, a polycrystalline graphite target inside it, and a fluorescent screen. If a voltage U is applied to the electron tube, electrons are accelerated and hit the graphite target, where they are diffracted analogous to the diffraction of X-rays. With the help of the fluorescent screen, impinging electrons can be made visible. Here, they produce diffraction rings. These are recorded by a camera. With a transparent ruler, the respective radius of the diffraction rings is read off. The diffraction rings vary depending on the applied voltage U. The higher the voltage, the smaller the radii of the diffraction rings. From the radii of the diffraction rings, the wavelength lambda of the electrons can be calculated. We conduct a series of measurements with different acceleration voltages and measure the diameters of the respective diffraction rings. Different voltages are applied. Then, an outer diameter and an inner diameter is measured. At a voltage of 4500 volt, the outer diameter is 4.1 cm and the inner diameter is 2.2 cm. At a voltage of 4000 volts, the outer diameter is 4.3 cm and the inner diameter is 2.5 cm. At a voltage of 2500 volt, the outer diameter is 5.8 cm and the inner diameter is 3.2 cm. Since large R equals 6.5 cm is fixed, the wavelength is determined by the voltage of the electron tube and the radius R as a diameter 2R and N is read off the fluorescent screen. Lattice constant of graphite D can be determined. For some voltages, the radii were measured and the lattice constants calculated. For the momentum of an electron of mass ME and velocity v applies, p equals me times v. If we equate this with the wave-particle relationship p equals h bar times k and take into account the relation k equals 2 pi divided by lambda of wave number k and wavelength lambda, we get me times v equals h bar times k is equivalent to ME times V equals H divided by lambda is equivalent to lambda equals H divided by ME times V. This is the de Broglie wavelength. The speed of the electrons can be determined by equating the kinetic energy of the electrons E kin equals 1/2 ME times V squared with the electrical energy E EL equals E times U. 1/2 me v squared equals e times u is equivalent to v equals square root of 2 e u divided by me. This yields lambda equals h divided by square root of 2 me times e u. This allows the determination of the de Broglie wavelength of electrons at any voltage value. Now we look at the geometry of the experimental setup. The scattering of electrons at the crystal planes is analogous to X-rays. For example, constructive interference always occurs exactly when the Bragg condition 2d times sin theta equals n times lambda is satisfied. Here d is the distance between the two adjacent atomic planes in the graphite. Theta the angle of incidence and n the order of the maximum. For small angles, the approximation sin theta is approximately theta applies, yielding the relation n times lambda is approximately 2d times theta, or 2 theta equal n times lambda divided by d. The crystals can be oriented in all directions in space, so that the diffraction patterns resulting from constructive interference are circular rings. The figure to the experimental setup shows the following relation. Small r equals large r sin 2 alpha is approximately large r times 2 alpha. From these two equations and the fact that the deflection angle of the electrons is twice the angle of incidence on the graphite crystal, alpha equals 2 theta equals n times lambda divided by d, follows d is approximately 2n large r times lambda divided by small r. Since the sphere radius is large r equals 6.5 centimeters, the wavelength is determined by the voltage of the electron tube and small r and n can be read off the fluorescent screen. The graphite lattice constant d can be determined. This results in the mean value d equals 217 picometers in good agreement with the literature value of 213 picometers. This experiment clearly shows that even massive particles have wave properties that can only be well explained in the wave picture.